Hello and welcome to the Slingshot channel. Well, as you see, the spring is here, so it's time to make another natural slingshot. And the folks at SOG Knives have been so kind to send me a few of their great S60 multi-tools. They even put my Slingshot channel logo on it. I'm going to show you how to make a slingshot just with this multi-tool. And by the way, you can win it. See the details at the end of the video. First, you have to find the right fork. This one is just about perfect. It's very even, has the right angle between the two fork arms. So we have to cut it here and here. For cutting, we're opening up the multi-tool. And we take out the saw, like here. Now notice that the blade locks in place, so it can't accidentally close down on you. And now we saw the fork off. And it's already a nice slingshot, but we will now carve in the tips a little bit because we want to use tubular rubber. And we're doing that first with the knife blade and then with the file. But first we press on this lever so we can fold in the saw blade and take out another tool. We'll use the knife and carve a little dent into the tip of the fork, like so. Here you can see the grooves. Now we will round the edges and we'll do this with a knife first and then with a file. This is how it should look like now. Absolutely smooth, no sharp edges. Now we're rounding off the butt side. It's finished now. It's time to add the rubber. We're gonna need surgical tubular rubber for it. I use TheraBand, but you can take basically any other latex tubular rubber that you can find. We have some TheraBand green. You can also take any other color really. And some string and a leather patch. You could also use strong textile. Let's cut it into shape first. We are unfolding the scissors now. We cut out a nice large piece of the leather because we want to shoot stones. Be careful with that knife, it's really sharp. See, I cut myself in the finger. In order to make two holes into the pouch, we take the knife blade and we cut in like V-shaped cuts, like this, and then from the other side. We now have two holes at the end of the pouch. Cut off a good length of the tubing. Of course, two pieces that are about the same length. We change over to the pliers, put the pliers through, and then we grab the tube and pull it through the hole, like so. What I love on the S60 SOG multi-tool is the transmission. You see that there is a lever effect and it's done with these wheels inside here. So this gives you a tremendous force and control about your grip. We take the scissors and cut off a little bit of the string, and that could be any string. Anything, shoelaces, whatever you can find. Now we tie in the constriction knot, and you can learn how to do this on YouTube. There's a million sources. And put it over the tube, lightly close it, and then we fold over the end of the tube, like this, and now we tighten the knot. And I do this with my teeth, but you can also use an assistant for that. More healthy for your teeth. like this, and then we tighten it. The constriction knot will not come off. We cut off the excess rope and rubber. It's amazing how sharp these are. And we do the same on the other side. This is how it's supposed to look like now. In order to attach the bands to the fork, find some kind of rubber. Can be any kind, office rubber. It really doesn't matter. Put the end of the rubber, of the tubular rubber, over the fork so that it kind of overlaps for a centimeter or so. And then you take the office rubber band, press on it with the thumb, pull out and wrap it around like this. When you're almost finished, put the tips of the pliers over the whole thing and wrap the last two rounds over the tips of the pliers. Then grab the end of the rubber band with the pliers and pull through like this. Now it's absolutely safe. This slingshot is finished. To draw out, you draw over the top through the grooves, and you could hold it either in the support style like this or in the hammer grip style like this. Now we need to find some nice stones. These would be good stones. They are of course not perfectly round, but large and heavy enough and not too edgy. For shooting, you always have to wear safety glasses. Believe me, it's necessary. You only have two eyes. Pretty powerful. Let's try to hit that melon with the stone. Worked pretty good. A lot of people ask me how to aim with the slingshot. I don't usually aim because I'm an instinctive shooter, so I would just draw out and shoot. But a lot of people aim, the target shooters, and they do that by holding the slingshot sideways, stretching the slingshot like this, drawing out to an anchor point, like the earlobe or the corner of the mouth, and then you aim over the bands. And you have to adjust for the height, and then you simply shoot. This is a wonderful multi-tool. I'm really grateful that they gave me a few of them. And one of them you can win with the original logo, probably the only one that is in circulation. All you have to do is follow the link in the text description to my forum and leave a comment, and the drawing will be in 1 week. Good luck. The spring is here, so we can spend some time outside again. And so I need a mini slingshot that I can carry around. Use very short bands and a very small slingshot. It actually fits completely in my hand. And it also has a magazine for 8mm steel balls. As you see here, it's held back by a magnet. The design is from a fellow forum member called LW. He invented this magazine. So what you do is you simply shake out around and the rest fall back into place, and then you can fire. To shoot it, you hold it with three fingers only, and then you draw out and shoot. Oops. This is made from plywood and orange Osage. Very nice. I like it. I got this nice letter from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. They obviously like my video about the condom shooter. I got some very nice kind words saying thanks again for bringing the condom call for proposals to such a big audience. And I think that's the manager of the foundation. Really classy. They could also have taken offense because my video was kind of, comedy. That's it for today. I hope you liked it. Thanks and bye-bye.